Just what are Frontier planning for Elite Dangerous in 2023? What are their plans? That really is the big question. Another big question some of you may have is me being on camera. When did this start? Well, it actually started yesterday. My first on-cam video was a Kerbal Space Program video. I thought I'd try another one here with Elite, and after many years of filming here on YouTube, well, I thought it time to shake things up a little bit. So let's see how all of this goes. At any rate, we're here to talk about the future of the game, and what better place to start than Frontier's roadmap. They released this roadmap in 2022, around about the middle of the year. It gave some indications on the updates we'd get for Odyssey. These two updates have now been released. It also gave us some vague indication that there would be a major game rework, a major gameplay rework, for the first half of 2023. Well, we're now at the end of the first quarter of this year, and we've got absolutely no news whatsoever about this planned rework gameplay feature. That is, aside from a very brief message that appeared on the forums last week. Let's read what Frontier said. Last year, we announced a major update that would rework a long-standing feature. This is still being investigated. However, a number of changes, not least the Thargoid War itself, have required our attention as a priority. We will share details of this investigation and our plans towards the end of this year. So a typically vague message there from Frontier doesn't really reveal a whole lot, but one thing it really does do is tell us that the update, the rework, is delayed. It's not going to happen in the first half of this year. Interestingly, Frontier don't acknowledge this as a delay. In fact, they don't even mention that they originally planned to release this update in the first half of 2023. They simply go on to say that, they've reprioritized, that they are now focusing on other things such as the Thargoid War, and that their plans for a gameplay rework, are now currently being investigated. Let's actually read that bit again. We'll share details of this investigation and our plans towards the end of this year. So that doesn't feel like very much of a commitment to releasing anything tangible. It feels more like a commitment to just letting us know what their plans may or may not be. So at this point, the update may release in late 2023, or could potentially even be pushed back into 2024, depending on what Frontier's investigations here actually come up with. But that said, there is another way of looking at this. The Thargoid War has had a massive impact on the game so far. But the last update was very heavily focused on it. The next update, Update 15, Frontier have stated, they have confirmed, will be another Thargoid War focused update. So it's quite possible that Frontier's work on the Thargoid War and all the UI elements and all of the background simulation elements that are going into this may have a knock-on effect for their planned rework. Is there a connection here somewhere? Is it possible that the work going on into the Thargoid War may directly be connected to this potential gameplay rework? Well, there's a number of theories as to what the future rework may be. We can have a bullet point list here. It may be reworking engineers, for example. It could be completely rebalancing the game in terms of ships and other content. Or it could very well be a rework and redesign of the background simulator. Now, Commander Burr of Burr Pit also had another suggestion here, which was some speculation as to the potentials of base building. Now, personally, I don't think that is going to be a thing. I don't think Frontier are going to put that much work into the update, but stranger things have happened, and I won't outright dismiss it. But I'll say that Burr made an exceptionally compelling argument on that, and I would highly recommend you go and watch his video. I will link that in the video description below. You can see a little bit of that plan on the screen right here. A great video, as always, from the Burr Pit. So, three things on the list here. An engineering rework, ship rebalancing, and perhaps other gameplay rebalancing, as well as reworking the background simulator. Now, which ones do I think is going to be the most likely? Well, we know it's only going to be a single core gameplay rework, so it won't be all of these. It could also be some other things that I haven't considered that aren't on the list. So if you've got any ideas on what you think it could be, do let me know in the comments section. I do read those comments, and they're always very interesting to see your thoughts and opinions on things. But personally, my feeling here is that an engineering rework is very unlikely. And the reason I feel that is because an engineering rework would not fundamentally change the game. It would improve the game, of course, don't get me wrong. We all know that engineering does need an overhaul, it needs rebalancing, but I just don't see that happening. Same for ship rebalancing. I also don't see that happening because Frontier have had more than enough opportunities at this point. But if we consider the background simulation, if that was going to be completely reworked, that could actually capture the entirety of the game and dramatically change how players go about interacting with Elite Dangerous as a whole. In fact, we've seen some of this happen with the Thargoid War itself. This is extremely notable when you check out the galaxy map. There's a whole load of interfaces here that indicate to players what is going on at any given moment with the Thargoid War, how they can get involved, and what they can do. Personally, I'd like to consider this as a preview, as a prototype of what Frontier may be doing in the future. So for example, if Frontier did want to work on the background simulation, we've got some nice UI elements here from the Thargoid War that could be extrapolated over, that could be improved upon to reflect the various factions that players could get involved with and help spread their influence across the galaxy, perhaps outside of the bubble as well, and into the outer reaches, into the interstellar space, into the depths of the galaxy, perhaps even some terraforming going on there, and space stations being built, and all the rest of that stuff. Now, when you think of it like that, it does put a very strong, compelling case towards a reworked background simulation. This would dramatically overhaul the game itself in some very fundamental ways. Consider for a moment that Frontier have paused player-made factions. That's not going to be a thing after this point. Maybe because, well, player-made factions may take on a very different role in the future. For example, players may be able to create factions directly in the game, or maybe be able to directly join the existing factions within the game, and then compel them forwards and project their influence across the galaxy. So yeah, ultimately, I do believe that there's a good strong case for saying that the background simulation, and perhaps even Power Play as well, could be reworked at some point in the future, and that perhaps those two elements would be combined along with the Thargoid War. So Frontier could combine the Thargoid War, the background simulation, and Power Play into one big epic update for the game itself. I do feel Elite Dangerous could do with something like that. It gives players a very strong reason to join in with various activities within the game and kind of knits everything together in a cohesive manner, something that the game is really lacking at the moment. So then, whether players want to get involved in combat, mining, exploration, some surface combat, or indeed anything else, it would all be knitted together in a whole united way, a unified way, and present an interface to players that would make a very clear sense, would be easy to read, and give players a sense of direction. So, as always, speculation on my part, this could go in absolutely any direction, but this is something I'd like to see. I'm not sure how many of you would like to see the same thing, though. Again, do let me know in the comment section below. Would you like to see a more compelling background simulation where players can very directly and easily interact with it in the same way they can with the Thargoid War? Would you like to be able to see players expand their faction's influence outside of the bubble and into the outer reaches of space, maybe colonizing new star systems, maybe having space stations constructed in those areas, maybe having planets terraformed even. There's lots of potential there. Sounds like a big update, but that could be the reason that Frontier have delayed this. It could be that Frontier really do have some big plans. But equally, it's possible that Frontier have just not been able to commit to this rework, that there's some internal reasons, maybe a lack of resources, maybe disagreements over what the update should be, or indeed some, you know, something else. It could be many different reasons going on inside Frontier that we'd never be aware of that have put a delay, or maybe even a complete end to this gameplay rework. This is something that time will only tell. Unfortunately, that seems to be the way it is with Frontier. It seems to be always the case. It just doesn't really seem to change despite their many promises. Although, to be perfectly fair, I think the recent Odyssey updates have indeed been very good, and I'm looking forward to seeing update 15 as well. But honestly, Frontier do need to improve their communications a little bit surrounding this rework, which is really a highly anticipated feature. It was a big bullet point on their roadmap from last year. At any rate, do let me know your thoughts and feelings about all of this in the comment section below. I'd love to hear from you. As always, thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys and girls next time.